Hey YouTube, what's going on? Hey, I'm back at you today with a couple new gear reviews. So I'm going to do a couple reviews today on this Mesa Boogie Mark III Red Stripe and also this Mesa Boogie Mark IVa head. And I'm going to be using this Ditto looper to do some tracks through them. So I'm actually going to use this intro video for both of the recordings since it's going to be doing the same tracks, and then you can check them both out and see what you think. I'm going through this Mesa Recto 412 cabinet with the vintage 30s, recording through this SM58 up into this iRig Pre and in my iPhone. over here for the guitar, I'm going to be using this ESP Horizon NT2, and it's loaded with the EMG JH headset, the Hetfield pickups, which they're definitely not hype. For an active pickup, they've got a real nice warm tone. You know, the drive on them, it's not quite as, it's different than an 81, but it's still really good. So, you know, I'm super happy with these pickups. So a couple notes on these amps. The Mark III Red Stripe, I've owned a number of Mark IIIs and played a number of Mark IIIs, and a lot of them have just been kind of harsh. I've got video reviews of some of the others that I've bought and sold in the past. This is by far the best sounding Mark III that I've ever played. So I think I'm gonna hang on to it for a while. And then the Mark IVa, you know, the A is a little more vintage and bright sounding than the B. I've also played Bs. you know, the B's a little bit darker. It's kind of split in hairs, but the main difference is the R2 channel. The R2 on the B is definitely more aggressive, whereas the R2 on this Mark IVa, you know, I think it'd be good for certain, you know, kinds of music where you're not looking for as much gain, but for things where you're using a lot of gain, you know, the R2 on this 4A is not that great. But with both of these amps on R2, if you add a boost in there, it really wakes them up. So if you're playing really heavy stuff, you know, you can do a boost on R2 and then keep the lead channel just for leads, and that'd be a really legit setup. But for today, since I'm just doing a playthrough, you know, I'm not going to boost anything, but just wanted to mention that. Anyway, check the videos out. I'll do the 3 first and the 4 second. Like I said, 2 separate vids, but I'm going to use the same intro so that you can go back and forth and check them out. All right, thanks. Okay, let's talk about this Mark IVa. It was originally a combo that I turned into this head. I had this guy named Scott make me a head shell. He does a really nice job. He's made me a few. I'll put his contact info down below. So this will, you know, once again, just be a knob turning playthrough. When you see me reach around on the back, over here, we've got the reverb. So I'll twist that. and then also over here, there's a button for harmonics versus mid gain. I'll flip that back and forth. I have to say on these Mark IVs, of all the Marks I've played, the IVs really have the best pinch harmonics, I think. So anyway, I'll just point to that and then when I'm flipping it. And then also on the back is the switch for the GEQ, so I'll point to that when I turn it on. And then the last thing, the R2 on these Mark IVs, the 4As, to me, you know, if we're playing heavy stuff, it's definitely weak. You know, if you're playing more, you know, less gainy type music, it might work out for you. But once again, if you hit that R2 with a boost, which I won't be doing today, it really helps to fatten it up. In the case of this amp in particular, I did have Mike B do a little mod for me that when you pull the fat on the R2 treble has more range. And you know, with the marks, more treble equals more gain. So you'll see that when I pull that knob on the R2 channel. But you know, once again, I'll just start out with the clean channel, then move on to the R2, and then move on to the lead. All right, so let's check it out. Thank you.
We'll be right back.